She's doing well. She is protecting the baby. She'll make sure she can get to the baby before you can.
This is the ultra-competitive and deeply rewarding world of breeding, the next generation of Kentucky's finest. Welcome to Foal Play. It's the middle of the night at Crestwood Farm, here in the heart of horse country, central Kentucky. This is when foals are typically born, under the cover of night, and tonight is no exception. The appearance of the mare's amniotic sac is one of the early physical signs, along with pacing around her stall and becoming more and more anxious. The experienced staff, including veterinary technician Ari Mars, stands by ready to step in and help the mare, but also to give her room, letting her choose the actual moment she gives birth. This is what the experts look for: the foal to come out in something they call Superman style, with the front hooves and the face appearing first. Everything goes naturally up to this point, but when things slow down, the staff decides to help the mare with a common foaling tool called leg chains. They don't hurt the mare or the foal, but they do help the birth go a little quicker and easier.
So when the foal first comes, we break the sac so the front legs are out so we can pull the baby out. When it comes all the way out, the back legs are still in the sac. So usually just try to get them out in case the mare stands up quickly or anything like that.
The mare is laying down in exhaustion, and the foal takes in its first breath. This is the magic of birth, of a foaling, and the beginning of a thoroughbred's life.
She's doing well. She is protecting the babies.
But there's no time to rest. In the wild, horses are vulnerable animals. Their natural instinct is to get up as soon as possible and be prepared to move to safety. This little foal is doing just that, taking its shaky first steps within an hour of being born. Next up for the foal is getting a pre-milk substance called colostrum from the mare. It's packed with essential nutrients that will help jumpstart the foal's healthy life. In this particular case, though, the mare does not have any available, but the staff is prepared.
So this mare was actually runny milk or dripping milk. So, you know, that could have been all of her nutrient supply dripping out. We can save their colostrum in case we need it for situations like this. So it's definitely not this easy when they start nursing off the mare. Takes a while to find it, but luckily we don't have to burp them. That's nice.
The mare and foal are doing just fine. They've gone through birth and the critical yet unsteady first few steps of life.
They're gonna teach the baby everything, manners, ground manners, how to act out in a field.
For the next year, they will be side by side during all hours of the day and night, the natural bond between mother and baby.